Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome to episode 4.
What are we doing today?
We are heading out to a new river. Hopefully also a spring creek. Fishing.
And what will we catch?
Trout. Brown and rainbow maybe. We'll see.
On dry fly or nymphs?
It's not that windy yet, but it's supposed to be windy, but let's hope for some dry fly action today.
All right. See you on the river.
See you.
Tuva found a fish that is rising a lot. It's rising right in front of her in super shallow water. Oh, now it's right in front of her.
Can you see it?
Yeah, you can see the wakes because it's so shallow. Came. Wait. Yeah, do you see the wakes now? That's where the fish is at. Just wait a little. Wait until you see it rise and then be super ready. Or that you see the wakes. Ah, come on. Ah, too much wind. Good!
Oh, he was... Ah!
What happened?
He rose further out. I thought it was on my fly, but it was further out.
It was not on your fly?
No.
Okay, I'm afraid that that he didn't like the strike, but now a little bit of sun came, so if we walk a little bit closer we should be able to see it if it's still there. Or upstream. Should we check upstream while we have some sun?
Yeah.
Okay, we're in the same pool. I just saw a fish rise in the current, so yeah, come and try this instead.
Yeah.
Walk slowly. The wind is terribly bad. Maybe it just moved up here and started to rise here. Yeah. Ah, could be good for the one that is there. Yeah, nice. What a cool take.
We have the same problem as
always. Be careful with it. Ah, the net?
Finding net.
Why don't you have... Holy shit, it's big!
It's a big one.
Let me get the landing net for you. One of you commented that we should buy like a magnet thing for a landing net, so we can always have it on our backs. Next time we go to Christchurch, we will do so. But we are far from there. Here! Landing net for you, lady. It's a beautiful looking fish.
It is.
You need to reel in more. Wait, go for it. It's not the most graceful landing I have ever seen, but...
Beautiful fish.
Is it?
Yeah. Look at the spots.
Okay. I will guess, I have not seen how fat it is, but I like to guess 1.9 kilos.
I think
2.1.
Oh, 2.26. So you were right. 1.9.
Thank you. release it.
Yep.
In the cold, nice water. Another one, about 2 kilos. Nice.
Nice. Great job.
I found a fish on a reef. I found a fish on a really cool spot. You can try to film it. On the other side, there is this dead brush, or whatever you call
brush.
It. I don't know, busk.
Bush?
Yeah, a bush, a dead bush. And right in front of it, there is a black or very dark looking fish. It's really hard to see that it's a fish when it's not moving. The question is, it's very easy to see. So is it a long lens or a short lens fish? Let us know before we tell you, let us know in the comments what's the best, the short lens or the long lens. But I say we go for the long lens.
Okay, you decide, your fish, you decide.
Yeah.
Okay. Then you can be mad at him.
And
in
I will
the
try the cicada. Yeah, or be mad at me in the comments. The cicada on its head, long lens.
Okay.
That's what we're going for. Perfect cast, no reaction. Well, maybe it landed a little short to him, so I try a little further upstream. Next cast, I try with a nymph. That's my indicator floating down.
So?
It didn't take. I had perfect cast with the cicada. And perfect cast with a nymph. I had a couple of bad casts first. It could be that it just spooked, but it's not moving and it didn't want to take 3 or 4 perfect drifts, so we'll not waste more time on it. We'll head upstream, we'll find another fish. And yeah, that's it.
See how it goes. So I think we will, leave it at that. The clouds are coming in and the sun is starting to get quite low, so it's hard to spot.
I have a suggestion.
Yes, okay, so we will not give up after all.
What was we were about to say? Thank you for this episode?
Yeah, I was kind of...
No. Oh, no, not yet. I was thinking as we were heading back and we follow along the main river, that we can put a streamer on. And just try, you can try a couple of casts in the very best spots and we see what happens.
I like that idea. Okay. Because I think the main river is more exposed to the wind. So we tried to fish there in the beginning, but it was hopeless. You couldn't see anything and it was super hard to cast the light flies.
But let's try. I think I'll have some streamers in the box.
Yeah.
And just try it quickly.
Good idea. Okay, let's do.
Streamer fishing didn't work, but we're on our way back, and in this little ditch, there is a little fish, like a kilogram or so.
I think that we can call that a little fish.
Yeah, I think we see it. Yeah, I see it. It's moving.
Oh.
Uh oh.
Coming. Nope. Rejected. Nope.
Not rejected.
What's going on with this
fish?
Yeah,
don't let it go way that way.
Water of life. Nope. Okay. Let's see.
It's the biggest small fish that I have seen today. It looked so small!
Look at it.
It's not that like golden as the previous fish I caught, but still.
Still. We had a good day of fishing that day, even with the clouds and the wind. So good that we decided to head back to the same spot the day after. But we wanted to try further downstream where the river entered the lake. Today is quite a cool day. We'll try to explore a big river delta. So there's a quite big river that runs out to this lake, and it splits up in many, many small streams and enters to the lake. It's like streams and lagoons and shallow areas like that. And we're just gonna jump from one section to the other, to the other, to the other, and just look for trout. Found a crazy place in one of the deltas.
We just spotted a small fish first, and Weber was like, okay, we need to find a bigger one, and I was a second later. It's right here.
That's the big one. Oh, here. That's a nice fish.
Yeah, it is. Oh, yeah, we have both rods.
Nice! Not really, is it?
First fish of the day.
Hopefully.
Alright.
Why don't I see where it went? Oh, it's coming out there now.
Yeah, let's go and explore some more.
Yeah. She found this super cool place. That is just the old riverbed, or maybe just one of the side streams. And it's super clear, and it's packed with trout of like 1 kilo plus, I think. And yeah. Here they look a lot fatter. And they're rising, they're swimming around. They're rising a lot.
So this is the third place like this that we've stopped by. And we haven't really we haven't been to the river we were supposed to be. But that doesn't really matter when you experience fishing like this.
This one is coming. This one is quite good and fat. You see it? Now it will come close to shore.
Yeah, I see it.
Okay, change to the long lens then.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice. Thank you.
We thought these fish would be easy to catch. They were happily feeding and we thought no one would have been fishing for them earlier. But it turned out that these fish were really difficult. They either just didn't want to look at our flies at all, or they refused them at the last moment. They were not really big enough for us to care to put on nymphs or really try harder to catch them. But when we finally reached the main river, we found a fish that we really wanted to try to catch. We came to this spot and we said, wouldn't it be nice if there was a fish in the, like, the slick current that is out here? And we come down and there it is.
Let's see if I can zoom in. I see it.
You can't?
Oh, I see it. I see it.
So I think it's I'll try the cicada and you will put on the long lens and we'll see if we can get a slow motion dry fly take. If we can, that would be amazing.
Yeah.
If we can't, well, then we try something else.
Yeah.
Even though it was so close to take the cicada the first drift, he didn't want to take any other dry fly. In the end, I had to put a nymph on, and I decided to put it without the striking indicator, just because I could see the fish so well.
You finally added on. It took a lot of attempts, but you got it.
Because the current is so strong here that I should just lift it up and walk 10 meters and let it go back in the pool that it was.
Yeah.
If that's the right thing to do, I will leave the net there and the rod here. Okay, I'll do it.
Yeah. Back to its spot. Hey.
Yeah.
Great job.
I think it was the right thing to do to.
Yeah, because the current here is quite strong, and if it was tired and it was so skinny.
After that fish, things went a lot smoother, and we finished the day off with a lot of great action. Cool.
Great job.
Thanks. That might be the last of the day. We'll see.
Have one more look.
One more. Nice. Nice. Ugh.
So Vebjørn has now found today's last fish. Alright. Let's have a look. See what happens.
Yeah, perfect.
Perfect.
No.
A bitter end to an otherwise great day of fishing. We hope you enjoyed this episode, and we hope to see you again in the next episode, where we both catch our PB brown trout on dry fly in some small backcountry lakes.